yes. The world is the eyes of a madman. Now, red means run, son. In numbers, they add up to nothing. That's a Neil Young. The powder in the finger. And it's a story about a rebel boy in the South during the Civil War. Decides to take on a giant flotilla coming up the river of Yankee Navy and Marines by himself. Circumstances just laid that in his lap. And he did it. And he lost. He didn't win. But he's decided, hey, time to go for it. And now, there was a few military stories. Okay, so there's a war going on. Now, of course, I had my family get together. And so, I have to do a poll. And I polled everybody there, and I said, do you guys realize that America is in war again? And not one person, and listen, I'm the only one without a college degree in my family, and not one person knew that Obama had declared war on these ISIS people. Not one person. So we're at war, and nobody knows, with the enemy, that we can basically attack anywhere in any country, even in the United States, and justify it. Because we're at war with an enemy that has no borders. They're everywhere, or anywhere, or nowhere. Who the fuck knows? Only the fucking intelligence people, I guess. And the people that, of course, we're making lots of bullets, we're making lots of bombs, and the military, little manufacturing, little sector there, and the economy is just trugging right along, and the investments are paying off. Because they're printing money to pay for this stuff. Because we sure can't afford it. We're not paying enough taxes every month to, you know, buy all the military equipment they're buying. And, you know, if you have a jet plane or a helicopter or a tank, any military equipment, you know, certain parts can only be used for so many hours and they have to be replaced. It's a never-ending fucking job. It's a great investment. And bullets and bombs, they can only be used once. Then you got to replace them. And you just don't want to replace one with one. You got to replace one with like hundreds. Because you never know what's going to happen. Now, I saw a story about this guy. He's a sniper. Now, I was in the infantry, airborne, a couple other places. And, you know, I got a lot of good training. I was in peacetime military. So we had tons of money just for fucking training. So I got a lot of good training. And that was really good because the military, they don't get that anymore. But we simulated. Now, we never got, you know, I was never in a war. I was in a peacekeeping force. You know, we got sniped on and stuff, but you know, those guys were just old weapons and they were like miles away and they weren't even coming close. We weren't worried about those guys. But now, there was a sniper. A couple of military stores are coming up because, you know, they want to get people to enlist and all that and glorify the military, glorify war, glorify killing. By the way, it's the anniversary of World War One, and during World War One, when the troops were going off to war in Europe, there hadn't been a war in 50 years. All they knew was peace. They thought they were just going to go and have a good time, have a few beers, you know, shoot off some guns and come home. Yeah, all the farmers thought they would be back home to do planting by spring in World War One in Europe. The Germans and Frenchmen and everybody else involved. In the United States too. And look, man, millions and millions of people just got maimed and killed and fucked in that war. But now this sniper, he got like 150 kills, he claims. Now, we were trained, like, if a sniper, like, kills somebody in your squad, you guys get down, right? And then, you don't fuck around and just try to run across the road one at a time. You fucking call in Hellfire. You call in fucking Charlie Company and tell those fuckers to lay down some mortars. You know, you take out the whole fucking grid if you have to get that fucker. You don't go in and try to lose more people. But to see, the thing, the Taliban, the people, they don't even have shoes, my God. Most of them were barefoot. And they didn't have the ability to call in artillery or mortars or helicopter fire. They didn't have that ability because they didn't have those resources available to them. So they just had to run across the street, and the guy sits there and he picked them off like a turkey shoot. But I can tell you what right now, if that was the Chinese, or if that was the Russians, or if that was a more advanced military that had these capabilities, that sniper, I think the sniper's lifespan on the battlefield is about 2 seconds. Against us, it was about 2 seconds. Because you kill one of our guys, we're going to have you fucking, fire is going to rain down on you and you're going to be dead. You and anybody around you. And the Russians and the Chinese are trained the same way. Now, of course, a Taliban or ISIS, they have a few machine guns mounted to trucks. They don't have the capabilities to come in and you know, level the ground you're standing on or building that you're in. They don't have that ability. So this guy is bragging for that. And there's really no right to brag. He should be ashamed of himself for killing so many people. So many people that he didn't even know who he killed. You know, a lot of reports says it was women and children involved, too. He just shot anything that moved. And there's no glory in that. You know, there's nothing to be proud of there. You should be ashamed of that. You should be ashamed you were in that situation. And you should have called in your captain or your chain of command and said, listen, you know, just drop a bomb on the fuckers and kill them all at once. Why am I doing this? Unless you're just one fucking sick individual. And even the guy that, I guess the guy that shot, he's claiming that he shot Obama. I mean, not Obama. Osama bin Laden. Osama, not Obama. And what's the glory there? I mean, you know, that's your job. You know, keep it to yourself. We don't want to know about it. Most people don't want to know about it. And if they buy the book, they're just fucking brainwashed stupid. And these guys are just trying to cash in on all this. They're just one of those people. They're trying to be one of those people. They're trying to butt up to them and be one of them. But they're going to have a hard time. Because it never pays off. Never pays off. And this guy, you know, I don't even know. Osama was probably dead already. There's no way he could have been living there, you know. Most reports, most credible reports. So, you know, it's one of these things. They're glorifying the military. That means they're gearing up for a big move in this war. So we'll be looking for that. That's all I had to say. You know, I hate war. I don't like the nukes. They're not using them correctly. Yeah, I don't like the oil spills. You know, I just don't like a lot of things. We're really fucking this earth over. And the earth is stressed. The earth is under a lot of stress. And all the animals, the trees, everything. You can look at everything. Look close in the dirt. Look close in your grass. Kind of study it for, you know, just look at it. See what's happening in your surroundings, your environment. It's not healthy. Everything's stressed. Something's going to break. Duck out.